So today we are going to see the experiment of mechanical heat pump. So basically heat pump is a device which extracts heat from cold medium and supplies it to high medium. Okay. So the main concentration in the working of heat pump is to remove heat from the cold side and supply it at high temperature side. So here we have a heat pump. So let us see first the different components. So we have a water tank. Now this water will be circulated through the evaporator and condenser. Now this heat pump, it works on vapor compression refrigeration cycle. So there is a compressor, then condenser, then expansion device, and then evaporator. So these are the main four components. Now for water circulation, the evaporator and condenser are tube-in-tube type of heat exchangers. So through the inside of tube, refrigerant flows, and outside of tube, the water flows. So what happens in evaporator, when water enters, the refrigerant absorbs the heat from the water. Okay. So the refrigerant evaporates. Okay, so heat is absorbed there. And now here, this is the evaporator coil, as you can see. Then this is the condenser, and after that this is the evaporator coil. Okay, so sorry, this is the condenser coil, this is the compressor, this is the evaporator coil. Okay, and this is the expansion device. This is a thermostatic expansion device. Okay. Now, how is the working? Now, the main components of refrigeration system, they work as usual. That is compressor, condenser, expansion device, and evaporator. Now, the main difference is here. The water is circulated with the help of the water pump, which is shown here. It will come in the evaporator, where the refrigerant will absorb the heat from water. Okay. Now this water is circulated then to the condenser, where the high temperature refrigerant will give its heat to the water. Okay. Now water will get heated. This water is again supplied to the evaporator, where again heat will be absorbed from water, and this cycle continues. Now if you want to make an energy balance here, that energy balance is heat absorbed from water in the evaporator by the refrigerant plus compressor work, okay, which is again supplied to refrigerant. Now this total heat is equal to the heat given by the refrigerant in the condenser to the water. So this is the energy balance here. Now we can calculate the COP of this system for two conditions. First condition, when we will concentrate on heating effect, that is we will concentrate on condenser, and second condition, when the cooling effect is considered, that is when we will concentrate on evaporator. Okay. Now this is a computerized system, that is all the readings, they are obtained on this computer. As you can see, these are the different readings, okay, which can be obtained, and the report can be generated from the computer. So the calculation part is, we have to calculate the COP for the cooling cycle and for the heating cycle. Okay. So that I will tell you later on. Here also, you can measure the flow rates. Okay. Here, this is the cooling water flow rate for evaporator. This is the cooling water flow rate. Sorry, this is the hot water flow rate for condenser,
and this is the refrigerant flow rate, which can be observed from here. And here the suction pressure can be taken from here, and the discharge pressure can be taken from here. That is, this is the condenser pressure, and this is the evaporator pressure. Okay. So, by taking all these readings, we can calculate COPs for heating cycle and cooling cycle. Okay. So, this is about this mechanical heat pump experiment.